students, in the last video we started with our chapter mineral and power resources, and we studied regarding power resources. So today students, we are going to start with our another topic, and that is conventional resources. Now what are conventional resources? In the last video also we discussed this. Conventional sources of energy are those which have been in common use for a long time. We are using these resources from a long period of time. For example, firewood, fossil fuels, etc. So two main examples of conventional sources of energy are firewood and fossil fuels. Now let us see what are firewood and what are fossil fuels. Let's talk about that. If we talk about firewood, students, in villages you have seen your grandmothers or your moms in rural areas cooking through these measures, cooking through firewood. And what are firewood? Firewood are example of conventional resources. And we are using these firewood resources from so long ahead. If you are going to ask your grandmother or your mother, they can tell you this thing better, that we are using these resources from so long. So basically they are used in villages for cooking food and doing other activities. So the remains of plants and animals which were buried under the earth for millions of years got converted by heat and pressure into fossil fuels. What we have said, what are conventional resources which we are using from a long period of time? Then we said that two common examples of conventional resources are fossil fuels and firewood. Firewood, which we are using for cooking, and these are specially used in villages, then is fossil fuels. What are fossil fuels? All those plants or all those animals that got died. And after getting died, they got buried deep inside the earth surface, and after millions of years, what happened? After millions of years, they got converted into fossils. They got converted into fossils. And what does that lead to? That leads to the formation of fossil fuels. So fossil fuels such as coal, petroleum, natural gas, these are the main sources of conventional source of energy. And again, I'm saying coal, petroleum, natural gas, example of fossil fuels, and it takes millions of years. When we buried dead plants and animals deep inside the earth surface, it takes millions of years for the formation of these fossil fuels, students. Thereafter, students, if you will see here, what you will observe, there are certain advantages and disadvantages also, which belongs to those. We are talking about here oil and natural gas. What we will say, if we talk about them, what are the advantages of oil? Easier to transport. It is very easy to transport oil from one place to another. Second one is basis of petrochemical industry. Oil is the basic of all the petrochemical industries. No chemical industries can run without oil. On the other hand, if we talk about natural gas, what are the advantages of natural gas? Easier to transport, same. Natural gas pipelines we have, we can easily transport it. Second is cleaner than oil and coal. Oil might conduct, you can say, disclean the environment, or is not suitable for us. It, you can say, is not suitable for us in the air, and we can face various problems like breathing problems, etc. So this is not a clean fuel. Whereas if we talk about natural gas, it is a cleaner fuel. And oil is costly, whereas natural gas is cheaper as compared to oil. Then is conventional sources of energy, firewood and coal. Again, there are advantages and disadvantages. If we talk about firewood, easy access, easily available, especially in villages, then is provide energy to large number of people. Then what are the disadvantages? Collection is time consuming. It is very time consuming process. If we are using natural gas, that can be done more frequently, or that can take less time as compared to firewood. Then it is polluting, obviously. If you are approaching to villages, you are seeing it is creating pollution. We have read there also, so it is not a clean fuel. Then is promoting greenhouse effect. Promoting greenhouse effect means the level of the carbon dioxide is increasing day by day. That leads to increase in the overall temperature on the earth's surface. That is, it also leads to deforestation. And if we talk about coal, it is extremely available. It's extensively available, and it is its advantage then is efficient conversion to electricity. It is very easy to convert coal into electricity. We can convert that, but in case of firewood, it is not possible. And on the other hand, if we talk about disadvantage, same, it also creates pollution, not a clean fuel. Then bulky to transport, it is difficult. Bulky means heavy. So coal is heavy in nature, and to transport coal from one place to another is one of the biggest tasks. Thereafter, student, hydel power. Hydel, what do you mean by hydel? From hydel we can withdraw the word hydro. Hydro means water. So hydel power means that power, that electricity, that energy that we are obtaining or that we are constructing with the help of water. But are the advantages non-polluting? Then is promoting irrigation and fishing. As I already told you, it's related to water, cheap source of energy. What are the disadvantages? Displacement of local community. If we are creating power, electricity with the help of water, what does that mean? We are creating it when water sources are available nearby, with rivers or lakes. So what will happen? All the local people who are residing nearby it need to displace from there. Need to displace from there means they need to leave that place from there for the formation of hydel power. Then is eliminates low-lying regions and expensive to set up. You need to spend expenditure to get hydel power. Now let's see students. Coal, I have already told you. We have discussed all this. Now let's just, in short, we have discussed. Now let's just see them in detail. Coal, I already told you. What is coal? It is one of the fossil fuels, and it takes millions of years to frame coal with the help of the dead plants and animals that are buried deep inside the earth surface. Then is, we use it as domestic fuel. Domestic means related to home. We use coal at home also. In industries also, such as iron and steel, and it is used to conduct electricity, of course. And electricity from coal, whenever we are conducting electricity with the help of coal, that is called as thermal power. Thereafter, we can say, I already told this thing to you, that millions of years took time for the formation of coal. So what will happen, that this leads to as buried sunshine. As we are burying dead plants and animals deep inside the earth surface for the formation of coal as a fossil fuel, it is called as buried sunshine. Leading companies or countries which are producing coals in the world, like USA, China, etc. Thereafter, students, next is petroleum. Now, what is petroleum? Petroleum, the petrol that we are using, and why, how we are using petrols, we can take the example for running the vehicles, we are using petrol. Thereafter, what we can see, that the petrol that keeps your car running, I already told you, it helps in running your vehicles. And what will happen, it is found between the layers of rocks and is drilled from oil fields located in offshore and coastal areas. In the coastal areas and offshores. Offshores means not nearby shores, but away from the shores area. We drilled out the rocks, we drilled out the earth surface, and then from the deep inside the earth surface, we used to extract petroleum, or we used to extract petrol. Then is, this is, if we are extracting or we are drilling the earth surface to obtain petrol, that is not in its pure form, that directly we can use it in our vehicles. No, it is not in pure form. From where? There we used to send this crude petrol to the refineries, where particular procession will go on in the industries, and then it will be converted in the form of diesel, petrol, kerosene, etc. And the petroleum and its derivatives are called as black gold. Now students, this is one of the very important questions. This question can be also asked to you. Which conventional source of energy is called as black gold? You can say petroleum, you can say coal. Now Another question can be asked to you, why petroleum or why coal is considered as black coal? Reason being, they are black in color. And black means black color and gold means something very precious. These sources of energy are very precious and they are black in color. That is why they are black gold. Why? Because they take much time, million of years to get framed or to get formulated. And that is why they are black gold and they are valuable to us. Now the countries that are supplying these like Iran, Iraq, in India we talk Assam, etc. That is natural gas, I already told you. That the natural gas is found with petroleum deposit and is released when crude oil is brought to the surface. When crude oil is brought to the surface, then natural gas what? Released. And it is non-polluting source of energy. We have already discussed that in diagram. It is both domestic as well as industrial fuel. Which are the countries that are producing natural gas like Russia, UK, in India, if we say Jaisalmer, near Krishna Godavari Delta, these are certain areas which used to produce natural gas. Then is there is sharp increase in our consumption of fossil fuels which has led to their depletion at alarming rate. Yes, as we are not using our resources in proper way, we are misusing our resources, especially natural gas, and this leads to depletion, or you can say because of the over exploitation of these resources, frequently these resources are getting exhausted day by day, and it is a cleaner fuel. We have already discussed that in that chart. Then is hydropower. I already told you hydro means water and power means electricity. What does that mean? The electricity that we are generating with the help of water. So definitely water dams will be constructed in nearby dams area where water is there. In science you must have heard about kinetic energy, right? So that particular format is there from very height when water is just falling down from the dam. Then with the help of turbine or machine it got converted in the form of electricity or power, and that is called as hydropower. Now where world, in which part of the world where hydropower is found, like Norway, Brazil, etc. Thereafter student, non-conventional sources of energy. What are conventional sources of energy? We have studied. What are the various type of conventional sources of energy? We have studied. Then are non-conventional sources of energy. The increasing use of fossil fuels is leading to its shortage. As I already told you, we are overusing natural gas, we are overusing fossil fuels, coal. That is why we are started facing their shortage, their scarcity. So what happened? It is estimated that if the present rate of consumption continues, the reserve of these fuels will get exhausted. What does that mean? With the pace by which we are using these resources, if we continue to misuse these resources in the same way, then very soon what we will find, we are going to find that these resources are going to be get exhausted. So therefore there is a need for using non-conventional sources of energy. So we need to use some other sources of energy which are permanently available or easily available for us so that we don't face any problem. Now what are these non-conventional sources of energy? Like solar energy. Sun is always here. So with the help of light of sun, we can create electricity. Then is wind energy with the help of wind. Windmills are there. Tidal energy with the help of tides. These are renewable source of energy. We can create them very frequently and very easily. Then is solar energy. I already told you with the help of sun, heat and light, we used to create electricity and that is called as solar energy. If you went to Rajasthan or Jaisalmer, you might have seen solar power plant there, where solar panels are there and sunlight used to flow through those solar panels and that got converted into electricity. That is solar energy. Solar panels, I already told you, we join and we use these solar panels to use light. Now again, this diagram is there to discuss about, before discussing about all these non-conventional sources of energy in detail. It is explained there in the form of table. First is wind energy. Advantage, non-polluting, not creating any pollution. That is low cost of producing. It is very cheap to produce electricity via wind energy. That is safe and clean. Disadvantage, noise pollution. Other disadvantage, it windmills to set up windmill is a very costly process. That is disturb radio and TV channels, you can say. Harmful to birds because red emissions are there, no? So it is harmful to birds. Then solar energy, inexhaustible, as I already told you. Sun will be always there in the sky. So it is inexhaustible source of energy, always available for us. Non-polluting, then is expensive. Setting up solar panels is a difficult task or is a costly task. Diffuse source and so gets wasted. Sometimes it gets wasted. Then is tidal energy, again non-polluting, inexhaustible. We can use it in an easy way. It is not going to over, or it does not take millions of years to get a frame. Disadvantage, destroyed wildlife habitat, because we are setting this nearby, you can say, where tides are there, coastal regions. Thereafter, difficult to harness. There is non-conventional sources of energy again. Nuclear energy and biogas. Nuclear energy, again, it emits large amount of energy. In nuclear, all of us know this thing. Generating nuclear energy means emitting, you can say, releasing large amount of energy. Disadvantage, generates radioactive wastes and it's expensive. Then if you talk about the biogas, again, this can be seen in villages also. Low cost, easy to operate, makes use of bio waste, for example, cow dung in villages that can be used to make biogas. Disadvantages, causes greenhouse effect, increasing the temperature of the earth day by day. Then is geothermal energy. What are its advantages? Clean and eco-friendly, is not harming the environment in any of the way and is always available to us. There is disadvantages. Located far away from cities and is costly to transport the electricity via this process. Now let us discuss about these in detail. I already told you about solar energy. Then if you talk about wind energy, I told you what happens in wind energy. We set up windmill at particular places, and when wind blows, that windmill used to rotate, and with the help of the rotation or the machine that is engine that is connected to it, we used to generate electricity. Advantages, disadvantages, we have already discussed. In world, we found where it is produced in UK, USA, Spain, etc. Nuclear power, I already told you. Nuclear power is obtained from the energy. Which energy? Which is stored in the nuclei. Nuclei means in the nucleus of atoms of naturally occurring radioactive elements have nucleus with them, and with the help of that nucleus, for example, uranium, thorium, with the help of the nucleus of these, we use to conduct nuclear power. Then is emits large energy. We have already discussed these points. Where in world it is found? In USA, Europe, etc. In India it is found in Jharkhand, Rajasthan. I already give you the example of this. Thereafter, students, geothermal energy. Heat energy obtained from the earth is called geothermal energy. The heat of the earth is also used to generate energy, is also used to create resources, and the energy that we are using from the earth is called as, or the heat that we are using from the earth to create energy is called as geothermal energy. So what is geothermal energy? Heat energy obtained from the earth is called as geothermal energy. The temperature in the interior of the earth rises steadily as we go deeper. All of us know this thing. In the starting of the chapters only we have studied this thing. That as we go deep inside the earth's surface, the temperature started increasing. Sometimes this heat energy may surface itself in the form of hot springs. It leads to the formation of hot springs. These heat energy can be used to generate power. You can see this particular formation here, how it is done to generate the power, and that particular process is called as geothermal energy. Now where it is found? In world it is found in places like in USA, like in Philippines, like in Iceland, etc. In Central America, of course, and India it is found in Madhya Pradesh, Punga Valley, etc. So these are the places where geothermal electricity is available. Tidal energy you can see here with the help of tide or heavy water turbine used to rotate that water, we used to create tidal energy or electricity with the help of that. Tidal energy, energy generated from tides with the help of tides is called as tidal energy. Again, we need dams for that. When I give you the example of kinetic energy, with very heavy speed the water is falling down, and with the help of turbines we are creating tidal energy. It is found in Russia, in France, etc. Then is biogas. It is organic waste. What do you mean by organic waste? Organic waste, you can say natural waste. I give you the example of cow dung, right? It is not harmful to environment in any of the way. We are using the remains of dead plants and animals for the consumption of biogas. For example, cow dung. For example, kitchen waste can also be converted into this biogas. Now, the organic waste is decomposed by the bacteria in biogas digesters, you can see here, to emit biogas, which is essentially a mixture of methane and carbon dioxide. So what is biogas? Biogas is a mixture of methane and CO2. So biogas is an excellent fuel for cooking and lighting. Natural source, not creating any pollution, and it's not expensive also. And the next is, energy is everywhere, but we can see that harnessing this energy is both difficult as well as costly. So setting up biogas plant is a costly process. Once it got set up, then it is, you can recover your cost, but in the starting you need to spend your money or expenditure for its setup. So students, these are the topics related to this chapter, and we are done with our chapter. So now we will start discussing the exercise questions of our chapter. So let's start. So let's discuss the question answer of the chapter, students. So the first question is, name any three common minerals used by you every day. We use various minerals like gold, like silver, copper, salt, etc. Then is, what is an ore and where are the ores of metallic minerals generally located? So what we can say, rocks from which minerals are mined, those rocks from which we used to mine or extract the minerals, formed as are known as ores. For any material to be called ore of any mineral, it must contain minimum adequate quantity of that mineral. So it is called as extracted profitably, so that we can extract it profitably. So what is ore? It relates to the rocks from which we are mining our minerals. That particular thing is called as ore. Then is, name two reasons rich in natural gas resources. In world we have discussed this, Russia and Norway. Which sources of energy would you suggest for rural areas? I have told you, biogas is very suitable for rural areas, because I give you the example of cow dung and kitchen waste that is easily available there. Then is coastal areas. Coastal area availability of water. What does that mean? Hydel energy or tidal energy. That is arid region where fertile soil is not there. Arid means not fertile soil, or you can say deserted land. I give you the example of Rajasthan, where heat is there. So you can say wind energy or solar energy. The next question is, give five ways in which you can save energy at home. There are various ways through which you can save energy. You can attempt this question in your own ways also. By not wasting water, by not wasting electricity, always switch off the appliances when they are not in use, etc. Then is, take the correct. Which one of the following is not characteristic of mineral? That they are inexhaustible. Minerals are exhaustible. What does that mean? They got exhausted, they got depleted, they got finished after a particular interval of time, and it takes millions of years for their formation. That is, which one of the following is not a producer of mica, Karnataka? Which one of the following is the leading producer of copper in the world? That is Chile. Then, which one of the following practices will not conserve LPG in your kitchen? That is cooking food in an open pan capped on low flame. Always remember this thing, you have observed your mothers also in kitchen. When they used to cook food, they always used to cover the cookers or whatever material they are using for cooking, because covering the utensils will always conserve the energy. The next is, students give reasons. Environmental aspect must be carefully looked into before building huge dams. Yes, of course, why or how? We need to see that the persons who are there, least person must be living nearby that area, because if they are setting up those, you can say, dams there, then what will happen? We need to displace all the people from there. They need to be dispersed from there. Sometimes it leads to environmental pollution, or sometimes it disturbs our earth equilibrium, it leads to greenhouse effect sometimes, and many others are also there. And setting such resources nearby, like rivers or lakes, is also a big problem. That is, most industries are concentrated around coal mines. Where coal mines are available, the nearby coal mines, most industries are there. Why? What is the reason? Because coal is used as a source of energy and power, and also as a raw material in most of the industry. And as coal mines are there, so raw material, that is coal, is easily available. That is where most of the industries are set up, nearby coal mines. Then is, petroleum is referred to as black gold. I have already discussed this thing, because this is black in color, and gold, because this is valuable, this is very precious. Then is, quarrying can become major environment concern. This is because of the following reason. It may destroy the humus of the soil, fertility of the soil, and once the fertility of the soil got destroyed, so growing plants and crops there is not possible. Then is, it produces a lot of noise pollution. Then is, it is a process of quality, lot of dust is extracted, which leads to breathing problem or other problems to the nearby humans living in that area. Then last is blast. Remember, student, when I was telling you regarding quarry, I tell you truth, in this process we used to blast the earth's surface, thereafter we used to take out the mineral. That point is mentioned here. That blasting done in the process of quarrying generally vibrate, which damage in the nearby buildings, dams and other similar structure. All the shaking vibration is done in the earth surface during quarrying, so all the nearby building used to get affected. Then we used to see cracks in those. Then is, what is the difference between conventional and non-conventional sources of energy? Firstly, we are using them for long period of time. They cannot be commonly used. Then is, they are generally exhaustible. Exhaustible, they got finished. They are inexhaustible. They are polluting, they are not polluting. For example, firewood, coal, for example, solar energy, nuclear energy. Biogas and natural gas, we use the waste of plants and animals for the formation of biogas, and we use the, they are found along with the petroleum deposits and gas released when crude oil is brought to the surface. That is, biogas is non-conventional source of energy, whereas natural gas is conventional source of energy. They are easily available in rural areas, where they are easily available in advanced areas or in cities. Then, this is polluting in nature and create greenhouse effect, increasing the temperature of the earth. It is a cleaner fuel. Which one? Natural gas is a cleaner fuel. We are using it as domestic fuel in cooking and lighting, and it is used as domestic fuel as well as industrial fuel. That is, ferrous mineral and non-ferrous mineral. Ferrous, Fe, is the symbol, representation of iron. A metallic mineral that contain iron, already told you, because Fe represent iron. Non-ferrous, a metallic mineral that does not contain iron, except those containing iron, ferrous mineral. Those not containing iron, non-ferrous mineral. Example, iron ore, manganese, etc. Example, gold, silver. Then is metallic mineral and non-metallic mineral. A mineral containing metal in raw form, a mineral not containing metal, example, bauxite, iron ore, example, limestone, gypsum, etc. And that's it about our chapter, students. We are done with our this chapter. Hope you understand the chapter well, and you will take care of this thing, that we will not waste our resources, because they are very important for us. Thank you, students.